Hello, welcome to my presentation. My name is Moses Kazungu. I work as a postdoctoral scientist at the Swiss Federal Research Institute in Birmingham, in Switzerland. Previously, I worked at the Tuning Institute of Forestry in Hamburg, where I researched how people use forests and what influences their behaviors in the forests. Today, the title of my presentation is Balancing Livelihoods and Forest Preservation, with a specific focus on charcoal production in the Miombo woodlands of Zambia. So, what's the Miombo and why did we choose to study people's use of forest resources in the Miombo woodlands? The Miombo woodlands is the most extensive dry forest woodlands in sub-Saharan Africa. It covers countries in Central, Southern, and East Africa. In fact, studies show that Miombo covers more than 10 countries located in these three regions. That's the Central, Southern, and East Africa. And it provides livelihoods to more than 100 million people who live in and around the Miombo ecosystems. In Zambia, for example, the Miombo contributes to household subsistence and cash income needs. It is suggested that the Miombo supports about 50% of rural households' income needs. It is also suggested that the Miombo supports nearly half of urban energy needs in Zambia. It provides revenues to the government through taxes, fees, and royalties collected. However, the Miombo is under threat due to extensive use, especially as a result of charcoal extraction. In this study, we therefore aimed to understand the role of charcoal production in households' forest use strategies in the Miombo areas in the Copperbelt province and assess livelihood capitals associated with forest use strategies in the Miombo areas of the Copperbelt. We use a sustainable livelihood approach to understand the relationship between households and forest use strategies. This approach suggests that within a specific context, households can use a combination of livelihood capitals, including natural capital, human capital, social, economic, and physical capital, to arrive at specific livelihood strategies, in this case, forest use strategies. But these strategies and livelihood capitals may also lead to deforestation and forest degradation. However, if appropriate mechanisms are in place, these strategies can lead to sustainable outcomes. We selected four landscapes in the Copperbelt province. Our landscapes constituted areas or landscapes with restriction in use of forest products and those landscapes with no restriction in use of forest products. We surveyed about 400 households, used cluster analysis to categorize forest use strategies and regression models to understand the determinants of forest use strategies. We found that quantities of charcoal produced in restricted landscapes and non-restricted landscapes varied. Higher volumes of charcoal were produced in restricted areas compared to non-restricted areas. We also found that households adopted three forest use strategies, which include pure subsistence forest users with about 50% of the households, specialized charcoal sellers with about a third of the households interviewed, and forest food and charcoal seller strategy. Charcoal livelihood strategies, in this case, they include specialized charcoal sellers and forest food and charcoal sellers, were the most lucrative forest use strategies, earning households higher income than subsistence use strategy. However, charcoal production was labor intensive and it required higher capital in its production. We used a multinomial logistic regression to understand factors associated with forestry strategies. We found that charcoal households, that is to say households that adopted specialized charcoal sellers and forest food and charcoal sellers, lived closer to exclusively owned forest lands but farther away from public forest lands. We also found that charcoal households lived closer to usable roads compared to subsistence households. We found that off-farm income increased the likelihood of households adopting forest use strategies. We also found that as age of household head increases and as household size increases, households are less likely to adopt forest use strategies. So, what do our results imply for policy and research? First, regarding quantities of wood extracted in restricted and non-restricted areas. Our results first have shown that extraction is higher in restricted areas compared to non-restricted areas, suggesting perhaps restricted areas could still be having production forests. Therefore, there is an opportunity to preserve and protect the remaining forests in restricted areas. But these results may also suggest that there could be ineffectiveness in the Zambian forest policy and regulation in the field. Regarding forest use strategies, our results have shown that forest use is intertwined with households' livelihood strategies. The results have also shown that use intensities vary across households. This may suggest that policies should be specific, targeting specific forest users. Regarding livelihood capitals associated with forest use strategies, our results have shown that livelihood capitals differently influence how households use forest use strategies. This also suggests that policies should be specific, targeting specific users. For instance, age and households, older households, and those with large household size have been shown to be associated with subsistence users. Therefore, a policy may target specific households with older heads and many households to improve their livelihoods. For instance, increasing off-farm access to off-farm income activities that may improve their livelihoods or incomes in the household. We therefore conclude that in order to balance livelihoods and preserve the forests, researchers and policymakers need to understand households' forest use strategies in the Miombo areas of Zambia. In this way, they will be able to design policies that target specific forest users and specific households in a specific location. Two, to balance livelihoods and also to preserve the forests, there's need to adopt sustainable methods such as restoration and coupling. In this way, we will be able not to compromise households' forest use strategies, but also preserve the integrity of the forests. With this, I therefore end my presentation and welcome you to discuss my work. Thank you for your attention.